Hello friends, my name is Sanjay Lakhanpal, and in today's hands-on lab we are going to learn how to load data from a file format which is Parquet. Parquet is a file format from an Apache Hadoop ecosystem, and it has a very good compression capabilities, and data is stored in a columnar format. In order to load data in a Snowflake from an Apache Parquet file, we have to first create a file format which is of a type Parquet. So let's start by creating a file format as a Parquet, and then we will start loading a data into a Snowflake. To create a file format as a Parquet, I will first create a external schema which is of a type file formats. Let's start executing this statement, create or replace schema, and we have given the name of that schema as a file formats. Under this file format schema, we are going to create a format of a type Parquet, as you can see in this statement. So let's execute this statement, create or replace file format, then we are going to give the name of a database and the external schema that we have created, and the name of the file format. The type is Parquet. Now, to get the data from our external sources like S3, we have to create an external stage. So let's create an external stage. Again, before creating an external stage, I'll create an external stage as a schema so that I can, whatever the stages that I have to create, I will keep all those stages into this external schema. Now, let's create an external stage which will point to S3 bucket. The same stage we are going to use for loading our data into a table. In order to create our external stage, we have to execute this statement, create or replace stage. Then we have to give the stage name. Here I have given as a Parquet stage, and the URL of the S3 bucket where I have already uploaded a Parquet file. Since I am using a secured AWS account, I have to provide the AWS keys and secret keys. These may not be required in your account, and we have to give the file format as a Parquet file format which we have created in the above statement. So let's execute this statement. Now the next step is to see how many files we have in this external stage or S3 bucket. To get the preview of the files, we have to execute this statement, list and the external stage name. As you can see, in my stage I have one Parquet file. Now what we have to do, we have to see the data in this Parquet file. Since we can't directly read the data from a Parquet file, we have to use a statement select star from a external stage. As you can see, I got a result from my query, and I can see there are multiple rows that has been loaded into a Parquet file. So from here you can see I have a nearly 2 million rows that are there in a Parquet file. To get the data, like this is a first row where we have a few of these attributes as an index level, category ID and other attributes. Now since this data is not having any attributes name, just only one attribute, and that is $1, we have to get the attributes from this Parquet file. So what we can do, We can separate out all the attributes from this Parquet file from the external shape that we have, and we can give them a name. These names we can easily get from here, like index level 0, category D, date, department ID, ID, item ID, state ID, store ID, and value. So what we have to do, we have to give dollar and then the attribute name from the file that we have just seen. So let's execute this statement. As you can see, I have formatted this data from a Parquet file, but still we have few issues in this file, like we are getting a double quotes here in a category, and the date is not a date formatted, it's a number. Also, you can see the quotes here in category ID and department as well as ID. So we have to remove these quotes and we have to convert these dates into a date format. So what we can do, we can cast these attributes based on the format that we need. So as you can see in my SQL statement, I have a date format which will convert these numbers into a date, and I have converted these attributes into a varchar 50. So let's execute this statement. Now we can see that the quotes has been removed from the category as well as department ID, ID and item ID, and the date has been converted into a date format. Now let's create a table and load data from this external stage into a table. It's a similar process as we have to load the data from other file formats like JSON. We will first create a table by using a statement create table and the attribute names and the data types. And then finally, okay, so let's first see how many records are there in this table. Since we have not loaded anything, so the number of records that we have in this table is 0. Now we are going to execute copy into statement for loading data from the external state that we have created above into this table. So let's execute this statement. It will take little time as my S3 bucket is on a different region and my Snowflake account is built up on a different region. So now here we got a result. It's nearly 2 million records has been loaded into a table. Now let's again execute a select count star from the table name and let's see how many rows are there in a table. So you can see I have nearly 2 million records in a table. Now let's do a select star from the table. So now you can see that I have a data available in a table that we have created in a Snowflake account. Thank you friends. If you like this video and want more videos, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you, friends.